Hello everyone, it's time to take the geode out of the mod, so you will see that in this video, but you can also going to see how I attach the acrylic crystals to the sides and also the clear coat I'm going to add to it, and also of course the end result. So for the people that are new or haven't subscribed and like tutorials about resin, please consider to subscribe. And if you do, then don't forget to click on the bell, because then you will get notified every time I upload a video, and that way you don't miss anything. So I already started with the demolding of my geode, and first I'm pushing the soft molding dough barrier downwards to get already a little bit loose the sides. There you can see it. Very carefully I'm pushing the molding dough down. And I'm very curious if it comes out easy. I hope it will. That I don't have much molding dough on the sides. And if I do, then I didn't apply enough Vaseline to the inside. So I'm pushing my acetate sheet also down to take it out of the mold. And there it's out. And now I'm going to see how the sides are. So all the materials, the soft molding dough and the acetate sheet, you can use again. You only need to clean it with a little bit of alcohol, and then you can use it for another project. So now I'm looking at the sides, and I have a little bit of molding dough on it. So I'm taking it off with a stirring stick. There you can see it. But there's only a little bit on. You can see it also in the front here. So I'm scraping it off. But overall the sides look very nice, because I was curious, but because I didn't use in my previous geodes so much crystals on the sides. So that was new, and yeah, now I know you can also use the molding dough if you have a lot of crystals on your sides. And I already can see that it shines through on some places. I like that. So also at the end of this video, close up with the light behind the geode, so that you can see in which places the light is shining through. And of course I want to show you the sparkle I added, the very nice holographic glitters. And I also have something exciting to tell you all. The pigments are available. My own pigments of the Just Paint line, pigment, mica pigment line, are available for the people in the USA and Canada. My associate Evelyn Shaver has them added to her Etsy shop. The name of her Etsy shop is Funshine Color Shop. I will add a link in the description box below this video. And there are also some amazing discount coupon codes added. So if you are curious, go check it out. And I'm very pleased that she already added them to her shop, so that you all can order them for the people that are interested in my mica pigments, because she can ship much cheaper than if I would ship it from the Netherlands. So please check out her Etsy shop and find out what the discount coupon codes are. So I'm almost done with the sides. Now I'm going to check the back if it's shiny or not, and it looks great. So no problems there. And the next step is that I want to add some crystals to the sides, so that it looks All the sides look all covered with crystals. Yeah, here you see me add the crystals to the sides. I'm using a hot glue gun. There you can see it. And on top, on the back of my geode, I have put some acrylic crystals, the same I used in the geode. They are clear, 6 millimeters. And with a stirring stick, I push them over the sides into the hot glue. There you can see it. I press them down with my finger, but you need to watch out because the glue is very hot. I burnt myself once, so that's no fun. And with the stick, I'm removing the glue threads. But I'm only going to show you some parts of it, not the whole process, because this is very time consuming. And after this, I'm going to add a clear coat, because I also need to seal in those crystals I'm now adding, because otherwise you can push them off. Again, with my stirring stick, I push the crystals into the glue and I press it onto the sides. I think this looks nice. So first a line of hot glue. There you can see it on the edge, and then I push the crystals into the glue. Little bit further in the process, because I want to do the whole side, so this was a lot of work. Yes, and also for this video, all the materials I've used you can find at the end of this video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites and also other information I've added in the description box that maybe you want to check out. Yeah, and I find this a nice way to give the edge another look. I like this. I never done this before. So I'm almost done, and then I will show you all how I add the clear coat. So I'm going to add clear coat, and what I already mentioned, I need to seal in the crystals I added to the sides. I always start in the middle if I apply the clear coat. You can see that. And then I make the circle more to the outside. Now I'm going to heat the resin a little bit so that it gets more liquid, so that it flows to each other. And now I'm going to spread it with my stirring stick to make sure that I have everything covered with resin, especially against the fire glass, but also the outside, what I'm now doing, against the acrylic crystals, because it doesn't look nice if you miss a spot. There again, I'm pushing the resin against the acrylic crystals. I'm also pouring some resin over the crystals so that it can flow over the sides, so that I seal the crystals in that I attached with the hot glue. More on the acrylic crystals. And on the fire glass. Again, some heat. And what I didn't mention, I also taped the back so that I don't get, if I get drips, that I can remove them very easy. And I'm using the masking tape where I also buy my resin. So the torch for the air bubbles, because I don't want to have any air bubbles in my resin. Doesn't look nice. So I will do this several times, also during drying. I go back and see if there are air bubbles that I missed. Also in the middle, some resin. More resin to the sides. Yeah, and if I apply the clear coat, I look at it in all directions to see if I have dust in it or hairs, you never know, and or where there isn't any resin yet. Again, the torch. And then I'm done with the clear coat. Need to let this dry. Then I will can show you all the close-up. So So this is how it looks with light behind it. So the sun is shining, so that's great. And I like it very much because I have some nice areas where the light is shining through. You can see it there. Because I made the sparkle white very transparent so that it will be translucent. But you can also see the sparkle, and that's so nice about it. Also the sides with all those crystals, it turns out very nice. Also there it's shining through. Also the middle part is shining through, so I'm so pleased I finished this project and it looks amazing. And I also am very proud of all the pigments I've used, my own pigments. They look great. So a little bit closer, there you can see it shining through, but you can also see the sparkle. And some cells. So that was a surprise, because I never knew that you could also make cells with only powder pigments, because I didn't use a paste. There I'm showing you the sides. So it looks very nice. I'm really proud of myself. There you can see the sparkle of the golden beach, the nice sand color, the middle part. So, and this is how it looks without light, and now I want to show you the sparkle of the holographic glitter that I added on top of my acrylic crystals, and also the nice copper that lays on top, and next to it the other glitter line. Yeah, it looks nice. You can already see the holographic glitter, the white glitter that I poured on top of my acrylic crystals. They go from yellow, orange, green colors. It's very nice. There you can see green already and yellow. It almost looks like opal, the real opal crystals. So this tests I did with the glitter, a very fine glitter, I think they turned out great, so I need to look into that further, because I want to also sell them in my Etsy shop next to the mica pigments. There I'm showing you the copper and the other glitter line. Very nice red-brown color. Also some yellow in it. The middle part with all those acrylic crystals. It's very difficult to film this because it sparkles so much and the camera has difficulty with focusing because of that sparkle. So another view, another angle of my camera. There you can see the sparkle white, very nice, and the white lily. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. I would appreciate that a lot. Don't forget to click on the bell. Then you get notified every time I upload a video. All the links for the materials I've used in this video you can find in the description box. Don't forget to check out the Etsy shop of my associate Evelyn Schaefer Fun Shine Color Shop. There she added the mica pigments from my pigment line Just Paint with the discount coupon codes. And within a few days I have also added them to my shop. So if you are curious, go check out the shops and all the information I've added in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.